Ladies and gentlemen, Litecoin has just halved their block reward. We've been going through this whole halving event, and I wanted to talk about what a halving is, what it means, and what to expect from the oncoming halving events in the future. Let's hash it out. So to kick things off today, guys, I want to talk about what a halving is. And to understand what a halving is, I think we need to talk about some of the core functionalities of a blockchain protocol. As you probably know, successful blockchain protocols like Bitcoin and Litecoin have a fixed supply cap. So they have a total supply of Bitcoins or Litecoins that will ever be created into existence. However, another key characteristic is that those coins are not all created all at once. They are not pre-mined. Rather, new coins are minted throughout the process of mining or reaching consensus on the blockchain network. This means that there is a fixed inflation rate for a given period of time as new coins are created and added to that supply. For example, in Litecoin, every time a new block is mined, as of today, 12.5 new Litecoins are created and added to the total available supply. And mining is the only process by which new Litecoins are created to go up to that fixed total supply. One of the key constructs in the security of networks like Litecoin and Bitcoin is that miners are incentivized, they are paid in the very network coin that they are working to create. So the network only moves forward if miners are doing their job, and miners get paid for doing a good job on the network and acting in a positive way. So these concepts of mining incentives, fixed supplies, halvings, etc., these are all key constructs that help secure the blockchain network and increase the value of these crypto assets. Remember that in blockchain protocols, miners are not working for free. They are working and they're getting paid for what they're doing. But they're also not working in an environment where their work is free. They're incurring significant costs to participate in the mining process. Remember that in mining Bitcoin or mining Litecoin, basically their computers are using vast amounts of electricity to iteratively hash, to create new hashes, to reach a certain target value, right? They're all competing as miners to win that right to mine a block. They're performing a crucial service for the blockchain, but they're also incurring significant costs to themselves. Now, why do they do this? They do this because they have the chance at earning a large block reward. And prior to the halving today, in Litecoin, that was 25 Litecoin. In Bitcoin, that's 12.5 Bitcoin per block reward. Now, it's always said that in a blockchain network, the more miners there are in a proof of work environment, the better off you are, the more secure the network is. That's because the total hash rate, the total compute resource pool is much larger. It makes it harder to 51% attack the network. It becomes a lot harder to game the system that runs that network. So the key is to keep miners incentivized to keep mining on the network and keep contributing their hash power. And as such, it's important that as we move towards the total fixed supply cap, that the crypto asset itself increases in value adequately to keep those miners incentivized to continue mining long term. Now, this is where halving comes in. A halving is quite literally a predetermined cadence on which the total block reward is cut in half. So in the case of Litecoin, just today we saw the Litecoin reward for each block that is mined move from 25 Litecoins per block to 12.5 Litecoins per block. This means that the effective rate of inflation on the Litecoin network as we move towards that fixed total supply is also cut in half from about 8.5% down to about 4.1, 4.2% annually. In Litecoin, it's around every 4 years where we get a halving on the network. And as a result, this reduced inflation and increased scarcity, because it's now more difficult to get Litecoin from mining, should in theory increase that value over the long term. That's the whole idea of a halving. You want to reduce the inflation rate, you want to increase the scarcity of that crypto asset, and you want to hopefully drive more demand for that crypto asset and thus push the price higher and incentivize more miners to come in and start performing work on the network. Now, you may be wondering, well, how does this make any sense? If you want to keep miners on board, you want to keep miners incentivized to stay, why would you cut their reward in half? And that is definitely true. Traditionally, we've seen right at the point where halvings occur in Litecoin and in Bitcoin, miners en masse that are smaller or more medium-sized miners that have older equipment, they can't compete in the network. It's no longer profitable for them to continue mining, and so they will leave. Right? They will leave to go find more profitable pastures, more profitable blockchains to mine in. However, this is where the benefit of paying miners in the crypto asset or the network coin that they're mining. Ultimately, this means that larger miners, miners who are more committed to the network, more specialized for the network, whether it's Litecoin or Bitcoin, they'll stick around. Why? Because they have more invested in the protocol itself, and they are probably going to be thinking long-term rather than short-term. This lower profitability is short-term pain for long-term gain. Likely, they have a significant interest in earning more of that Bitcoin at lower prices or more of that Litecoin at lower prices. And they think that as that scarcity takes hold, as the lower inflation takes hold, the market will start to value that crypto asset higher and higher. Thus, they're sitting on what is effectively a gold mine. So this means that larger miners are likely to stick around, stay put, and continue to mine even as that profitability drops in the short term. To me, this is one of the key values of paying miners in those network coins, because it incentivizes them and it creates long-term incentive for them to stay mining on the network that they're on. They want to have as much invested in that network as possible to keep their hash rate on board. And in this way, halving is truly ingenious because it's set forth in the protocol. No one has control over it, but it's a predictable occurrence every X number of blocks, every X number of years that miners can plan for and prepare for. It's also a point at which the economics of Bitcoin or of Litecoin change in a very predictable way. Rather than being an inflationary asset with a completely wide open supply, where we have no idea how many could totally be in existence, you instead have an asset with a very predictable total supply cap, with a predictable inflation rate that is actually deflating over time. It's becoming more scarce over time. And in this way, it helps increase that value as it gets harder and harder to mine blocks, as it gets harder and harder to earn more Litecoin or more Bitcoin for each block that's mined. The value should be increasing steadily to make that block reward still adequate to keep miners on board. And as we approach the total fixed supply, when there's no more halvings, when there's no more block reward at all, you want that asset to be rich enough, to be scarce enough, and to be valued high enough for miners to subsist on transaction fees and other methods of incentive on those networks. Halving is a way to kind of drive that value up over time steadily, rather than trying to make it all happen at once. So a halving occurs for two reasons: to increase scarcity and decrease inflation, thus creating upward price pressure on that crypto asset, and two, to slow the roll to the total fixed supply. The slower you get to that total fixed supply cap, the slower that we reach that, and the more gradually you reach the higher prices that that crypto asset will eventually have based on the scarcity levels, the better off you are. So it's to increase that price using scarcity and inflation rates over time, and it's going to slow your roll to the total fixed supply. In previous halving events, we've seen the price skyrocket early and then drop back down and then come back up. There's been no real surefire way of guessing where the prices are going to go in the short term. But long term, the network starts to price itself based on the scarcity of that asset. This is no guarantee of profit. This is no guarantee of a get rich quick sort of scheme. There never is one. However, as the market reacts and the dust settles, by and large, the entire point of a halving is to help drive that crypto asset's value higher as we move towards that total fixed supply cap. So it remains to be seen what will happen when Litecoin's halving dust settles and we see really what's going on with the market and how many miners have jumped ship. And we also have a Bitcoin halving coming up next year in 2020. So we shall see what happens. I'm very stoked to see what's gonna happen with this Bitcoin halving as well. And guys, with that, please do not forget to check out some more of my content. I've got a cool video right here for you to check out and one right here for you to check out. Thank you very much for all the time you spend on my channel. Cheers.